one day everything changed. You're all I need.
Thank you so much for listening. Fionn Upton of Oxfordshire, text of the day. Thanks for kicking me into a Christmas mood today, Saz. Was feeling pretty bad, humbug. Now I'm inspired to drink mulled wine and start the dreaded Christmas shopping. It's Christmas, she says. You've been great. See you tomorrow from 4 for all requests. Joe on the way. This is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 7 o'clock. This is Catherine Cracknell. Nearly one in three patients arriving at hospitals in England by ambulance last week had to wait at least 30 minutes to be handed over to A&E teams, according to the latest official figures. The data coincides with separate figures, which show job vacancies across NHS England have risen to a new high, with more than 130,000 full-time positions unfilled. Professor Alison Leary, who's an expert in the health workforce at London South Bank University, says it's a very serious situation.
Consequence of that is the work that isn't getting done, and this manifests itself in things like care that's left undone on hospital wards, district nurses that are not able to see all of the patients, and also the obvious issues with ambulance queues outside emergency departments. There are quite often recruitment drives, but quite often that's a reliance on sort of the newly qualified, and it's the retention of experts that we actually need to focus on.
Prominent activists and equality campaigners have been voicing their support for a black charity worker who says she felt abused after being quizzed about where she came from at a Buckingham Palace reception. Ngozi Fulani said the conversation with Lady Susan Hussey was like an interrogation. Lady Susan's apologised and resigned from her position as a royal aide. But the author and broadcaster, Geoffrey Boache, says the incident illustrates a need for some re-education.
The whole episode to me was emblematic of an institution that has struggled to be inclusive, that continues to struggle to be inclusive, and has kind of to be shown what that looks like and what that feels like for people on the receiving end.
The leader of the SNP at Westminster, Ian Blackford, has denied claims from the Scottish Conservatives that his decision to resign from the role was a case of jumping before he was pushed. The MP for Ross Skye and Lochaber had held the position for 5 years, but said it was now time for fresh leadership ahead of the next general election. President Emmanuel Macron has said France and the United States need to become brothers in arms once more now that war has returned to Europe. He was speaking on his arrival at the White House for a state visit. Football, and Germany's critical match against Costa Rica at the World Cup in Qatar has just kicked off for the first time ever at the men's tournament. The match is being officiated by an all-female team led by head referee Stephanie Frappa. Georgia Rooney, who works in grassroots football, says tonight will help encourage young girls to take up the sport.
It's great. Stephanie Frappa is a complete inspiration, and it's particularly good that she's refereeing men's football too, because it shows women and girls that they don't have to restrict themselves, for example, to the women's game if they don't want to, and that they can also reach that level. So it's really amazing to see.
And the weather, mist and fog developing in many places, with some patchy rain in northeast Scotland and the odd shower in southeast England as well. That's the BBC News at coming up to 7:03.
Thank you, Catherine.
Joe Wiley's Shiny Happy Playlist.
There's going to be big tunes
blowing the roof off Radio 2.
Shiny Happy.
If you want to get absolutely bouncing,
this is where it's at. BBC Radio 2.
And thanks to Sarah. So Christmas is here then, apparently. I've been listening to Radio 2 all day long. Zoe officially launched Christmas here on The Breakfast Show, and we're going to carry that on throughout the programme this evening, especially with our Thursday theme, which is for all the people who are very busy out there. But mostly we're going to be all about the Shiny Happy Playlist right now. So if you would like a mention on the radio tonight for yourself or for somebody else out there, tell me what your gang is all about this evening, your tribe, be it a tribe of one or tribe of many. 88291 joe.wiley@bbc.co.uk.
The Shiny Happy Playlist on BBC Radio 2.